Dr. Dave Luce, and I suppose you could call me the inventor of the Polymoog keyboard. In order to put this instrument in perspective, I'd like to give you a little historical background. Names such as Bob Moog, Walter Carlos, Garth Hudson, Keith Emerson come to mind in discussing the development of the Polymoog keyboard. Incorporating these ideas of all of these people has helped us to refine the concept of preset control as well as variable control, which makes the instrument more playable. This technical background is necessary to help you understand better the performance capabilities of the instrument. Perhaps the most important part of the development of the Polymoog was the development of a special integrated circuit or chip. Without this component, the size of the Polymoog would be many times its present size, and the cost of the Polymoog would be several times its present cost. Creating the Polymoog cost $500,000, of which a significant fraction was spent for designing this special integrated circuit. When notes are played on the touch-sensitive keyboard of the Poly, the chips are activated. The chips generate the basic sound using inputs provided by the player, either through the preset controls or through the variable controls. The timbre of the sound is then further modified using either the filters or the resonator sections on the Poly. The Polymoog works the way a musician thinks. Mike Boddicker, a prominent Los Angeles studio musician, can best demonstrate the translation of our electronic breakthrough to the performance of music.
To begin to play the Polymoog, we first focus our attention to the center of the console, which is a series of presets called modes. At the touch of a button, we have our choice of 8 basic sounds. Let's listen to a few. Here's piano. Strings. Harpsichord. Organ. Clavinet. There's even one selection that places the Poly in a completely variable mode, allowing you to program your own sounds using the sliders. Now that we've covered the building blocks of the Polymoog, let's get into the unique features that allow us to become more creative. We'll start with the Vibes mode. And vary that sound by bringing up the VCF slider. Using the clavinet mode, I'll modify it by bringing in the loudness contour and then raising the resonator slider so that the clavinet mode becomes a double reed sound. What you've been hearing here are just a few of the possibilities. There are thousands of variations. Here's another interesting variation of the piano mode. An additional feature of the Polymoog is that you can split the keyboard. On the upper 4 octaves, I'll play clavinet with wah-wah, and on the lower part of the keyboard, I'll play a bass line. To demonstrate one of the capabilities of the Polymorph pedal, I'll use it to bend pitch. I'm a studio player, and I like the Poly because it's fast to program, and thus it saves me studio costs. But because it is easy to program, it also lends itself beautifully to live performance.
The idea of a polyphonic synthesizer is great. I now know the experience of playing the synthesizer with one note at a time. But the Polymoog is the first one that I came across where you can use a whole keyboard, and it's a synthesizer. You can set it like a synthesizer and use all the functions of the synthesizer, and it just makes that much more fun in being able to use that kind of sound. The Polymoog has 9 presets on it, and what can be done is just by touching one of the presets, there's a totally different sound there, which makes it easy to change from one sound to another. Each preset that's pressed, you have a basic sound there, which can also be altered with the regular synthesizer alterations, like filter and like attack and the various other things. So the control panel is right there. It's very easy to manipulate the sound as one is going through a piece of music. The way I've used electronic instruments in general is during the course of a performance, I'll find one or maybe two sounds that I really like and that I use in certain compositions. Because I don't like to switch and turn and do a lot of things in performance. I just like to play. The Polymoog has a great keyboard. One of the things that I found really lacking in all electric instruments is not a real nice feeling in the keyboard. I mean, I'm used to playing grand pianos that have been developed and evolved over years and years to have a really good action and nice touch to them. The Polymoog is the first electronic instrument that has a really fine, nice, solid touch to it. I really like it. On the Romantic Warrior, the album I did with Return to Forever, the newest one, I conceived of the sounds that I wanted as background, mostly orchestral type sounds, and a few sounds to use as solo voices. I used a harpsichord-like sound in one piece, Majestic Dance, but mostly like orchestral sounds. So what I did was, after the basic tracks were laid, I went out into the studio and spent a few minutes to find exactly the right sound and overdubbed them on the record. There were a couple that were really surprising to me, like a really brass type sound that I didn't think could be gotten from the instrument, and then some string sounds which were really, really nice. I found out something recently that the Polymoog can do, which I haven't actually tried yet, which I'm going to as soon as I get to practicing it again. Other synthesizers can be plugged in to the Polymoog. For instance, the Micromoog, or the Minimoog, or the 15, which are instruments that I've been using, can be patched into the Polymoog and just with the switch of a foot pedal, be there available to play from the Polymoog keyboard. Stanley, Lenny, and Al really loved the sounds that were gotten out of the Polymoog, especially Lenny. We spent some nice time during the Romantic Warrior finding sounds for his piece on the record, The Sorceress, and they're just really pleased with it, too. There's a pitch controller, too, on the Polymoog, which is nice. Usually they go up and down, the ones
ones I've seen. This one goes side to side, which is nice because the hand can be like this. And one thing I like it for is to use finger kind of a vibrato, which is very similar to the way string instruments are played. Like that, it's a nice natural movement. And then another thing which is a freak out really is you can play a chord and then move the whole chord up or down. So with the Polymoog, I could see that it's very easy to find just the settings I need for the compositions that I'm going to do and have them there at a touch of a finger.
As a piano player, I can't tell you how great it is to have a synthesizer that lets me use my left hand. I've spent most of my life developing chops that until now couldn't really be demonstrated on a synthesizer. Since the Polymoog allows me to use both hands, you know, any number of fingers, then I'm free to use my left hand for bass lines while I'm playing melodic lines with my right, or while I'm playing chords with my right, or if I'm playing melodies with my right hand, I can play chords with my left hand. There's so many different possibilities, even playing melodic lines in both hands moving in opposite directions. It's a fantastic feature, and a wonderful kind of freedom of expression because of this feature. When I'm using the Polymoog in concerts, because it's a synthesizer, I'm able to reproduce not only acoustic sounds, the sounds of acoustic instruments, but I'm also able to create my own sounds. And because it's polyphonic, it allows me even more possibilities for color. On my more recent recordings, I've used synthesizers to simulate string sounds, but in many cases I've had to overdub maybe 3 or 4 times because most synthesizers are not polyphonic and you can only play 1 or 2 notes at a time. But with the Polymoog, since it is polyphonic, I'm able to have a whole string section at my fingertips. Not only that, but I'm not restricted to having just a preset string sound or any preset sounds. I'm able to vary the presets with just a flip of a few switches, like this. Such a marvelous instrument is the fact that it's a dynamic keyboard, and that means that I can play loud and soft with the touch of my fingers, just like I can on a grand piano. Not only that, but you can vary the degree of dynamics. Listen to this. So here we have a dynamic keyboard and a polyphonic synthesizer that I can play with both hands.